हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सेक्शन 13 ऑफ हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट. सेक्शन 13 ऑफ हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट, इट इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ द एंटायर फैमिली लॉ. व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट हिंदू लॉ, इट इज़ अ पर्सनल लॉ एंड ओनली द पार्टीज हु आर हिंदू दे आर गोइंग टू बी गवर्न अंडर दीज प्रोविजंस विच आर स्पेसिफिकली मेड फॉर द हिंदू कम्युनिटी. सो व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सेक्शन 13 इज टॉकिंग अबाउट one matrimonial relief given in the Hindu Marriage Act, and that matrimonial relief is divorce. Divorce means dissolution of marriage between two parties. Parties who are Hindu, if there is any marriage solemnized between two parties, okay, as per the provisions of Section 5, the marriage was a valid marriage. In that situation, there are few grounds given under Hindu Marriage Act for the dissolution of marriage. After divorce, the parties are not having any rights, any obligation towards each other. Okay, and remember, only after the commencement of Hindu Marriage Act, we do have provision relating to divorce. Previously, in the ancient Hindu law, we were not having any provision like divorce. Okay, somehow we borrowed this particular provision from outside. But now there are few grounds given under Section 13. They are talking about these are the ground for the divorce under Section 13. Remember Section 13 Clause 1. Okay, 13 Clause 1, which is talking about either of the parties may file a petition on any of the grounds given below to the district court, to the family court or city civil court. These are the grounds available to the parties on any of these grounds. So the ground which is given in the Section 13 Clause 1, it is available to both the parties. Husband or wife can file a petition for the divorce on any of these grounds. The first provision which is discussed here, it is adultery. If husband or wife voluntarily have sexual intercourse with any of the third party who is not the spouse, it is a ground for divorce. Okay, so it is a ground for divorce under Section 13(1)(1). Again, 1A and 1B, there are two specific provisions are given under Section 13(1). So adultery means sexual intercourse between the two parties other than the spouse. It is a ground for divorce. Remember, we have a provision relating to adultery in the IPC. In that situation, it is amount to a criminal offense. And here, under Section 13, Clause 1, subclause 1, it is just a ground. We are not making any kind of criminal case against a person on the ground of adultery. It is a ground available to the party. If husband or wife have a sexual intercourse with the third party, on this ground, the other party who is the aggrieved party may file a petition for the divorce. It is a ground for divorce. It is not a criminal offense like IPC. So first is adultery. In the first sub-clause, there are two other things are given, cruelty and desertion. Okay, cruelty is added as a ground for divorce, and desertion for a continuous period of 2 years, it is also a ground for divorce. Remember, we are having different provisions for cruelty and different remedies for cruelty. Okay, in case we are having Domestic Violence Act, it is also talking about the cruelty, physical, mental, verbal, emotional, economical. So there are certain kinds of cruelty discussed in the DV Act, but the approach towards the law is completely different. So the remedies which are provided in the Domestic Violence Act, these provisions are not talking about the dissolution of marriage. They are not talking about such kind of remedies. But under Section 13, cruelty may be a ground for divorce. Okay, under 498A, it is a criminal case against the husband or his family members. Female can file a petition. Okay, here under Section 13(1)(1), on the ground of cruelty, a male can also file a petition. So these are the various provisions of cruelty, Domestic Violence Act, IPC, ओके एंड सेक्शन 13 ऑफ हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट. सो वी आर हैविंग सो मेनी प्रोविजन रिलेटिंग टू क्रुएल्टी, बट रिमेंबर हियर इन हिंदू मैरिज एक्ट क्रुएल्टी इज जस्ट अ ग्राउंड. ओके, वी आर नॉट पनिशिंग द पर्सन फॉर हिज ऑफेंस. ओके, इट इज जस्ट अ ग्राउंड कि हस्बैंड इज कमिटिंग क्रुएलिटी और वाइफ इज कमिटिंग क्रुएलिटी, एंड दैट्स वाई वी आर मेकिंग अ पिटिशन कि आई एज अ पर्सन आई एम नॉट एबल टू लिव विद दैट पर्टिकुलर स्पाउस. ओके, सो इन दैट सिचुएशन क्रुएलिटी अंडर सेक्शन 13 क्लॉज 1(1)(a) इट इज अ ग्राउंड फॉर डाइवोर्स. सेकेंड, डेजर्शन, नॉट लिविंग विद द अदर पार्टी. ओके, डेजर्शन, त्याग देना, छोड़ देना. डेजर्शन इज अ ग्राउंड फॉर डाइवोर्स इफ द स्पाउस लेफ्ट द कॉन्जुगल सोसाइटी फॉर अ कंटिन्यूस पीरियड ऑफ 2 years. ओके, आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ 2 years इट बिकम्स अ ग्राउंड फॉर द डाइवोर्स. तो द मेन एंड द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग हेयर, इट इज अ ग्राउंड फॉर डाइवोर्स अंडर सेक्शन 13(1)(1)(b). सेकेंड थिंग, 13(1)(2) इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द कन्वर्जन. दिस एक्ट इज एप्लीकेबल टू द हिंदूज. Okay, when we are talking about the valid marriage, section 5 is there, which is talking about certain kinds of essentials of a valid marriage. And here, if either of the spouse converted himself or herself in any other religion, it is a ground available to the party, because now this act will not be applicable to that person. So conversion is a ground for divorce here. Adultery, 13(1)(1), 13(1)(2), conversion. Third, unsound mindedness. Remember, if person is incurably unsound mind, and that's why the petitioner is not able to live with that party, it is a ground for divorce. Okay, it may be a physical unsoundness, it may be a mental unsoundness. It depends case to case, circumstances and facts. Then leprosy, incurable form of leprosy. Now it is curable. Now we are having certain medicines to cure this particular disease. But now the act is not yet amended, and we require the amendment in this particular provision. The leprosy, if a person is suffering from leprosy and it is an incurable form of leprosy, it is a ground for divorce. Next, venereal disease. So there are various venereal disease, okay, like AIDS, and it is not curable. In that situation, the other party may leave the conjugal society and they can make a petition under section 13 for the divorce. Then renounce the word. We are talking about the Hindu law. Under Hindu Marriage Act, it is a ground if person, it is equivalent to the civil death of a person. Okay, when we are talking about renounce the word, if a person left the world, okay, because of certain religious reason, he became yati, he became sannyasi, in that situation it is also a ground for divorce. So, and the last one, if any of the person, any of the parties who has not been heard from last 7 years, that person is alive. Okay, we are not having any information that person is dead. We are not having any information that person is alive. In that situation, it is also a ground for divorce. So, in total, 9 grounds, and as per the provision, 7 grounds are there for the ground of divorce. And these 9 grounds are available to both the party, husband and wife. Second thing, 13(1) is talking about the grounds available to both the party. Remember the specific provision 13(1)(a). Okay, here we are talking about 13(1), capital A is there. It is having a special provision for the divorce. Okay, most of the cases in the court, they are going on this particular ground. Okay, if, suppose, under section 10, a decree of judicial separation is passed by the court. Decree of judicial separation is passed by the court, and even after completion of 1 year, there is no cohabitation between the parties. In that situation, they can file a petition for the divorce under section 13(1)(a). Judicial separation, decree passed by the court, completion 1 year, no cohabitation between the party. It is a ground for divorce. In the same manner, 13(1)(a)(2), which is talking about RCR. A decree of RCR is passed by the court after completion of 1 year. There is no cohabitation. It is a ground for divorce between the parties. Okay. Now, section 13(2). 13(1), the rights are available to both of the parties. Total, in total, 9 grounds. 13(1)(a), both the parties are available to specific ground based upon the decree of the judicial separation or on the decree of the restitution of conjugal right. Now, section 13(2), there are 4 grounds available to the wife only. Remember, prior to 1955, we were not having any law. We were not having any law relating to marriage or divorce or adoption. So we were completely dependent upon the uncodified Hindu law's provision. Okay. So if a marriage is solemnized prior to 1955, okay, the person who was having two wives and the husband got married with two women prior to 1955, the both the marriages were valid marriage, but after the commencement of the act, it is not allowed. Okay, so if a person, suppose X is having a wife number 1 and wife number 2, marriage in 1950, the marriage in 1951, the second wife is having this particular ground 13(2)(1). Okay, if there is a marriage prior to 1955, a person is having a legally wedded wife, the second wife can apply for the divorce under section 13(2)(1). Okay, so if the marriage between the person and that lady was solemnized prior to 1955 and before the commencement of Hindu Marriage Act, in that situation, this is a special ground available to the second wife or third wife. Okay, that person is having already wedded wife, okay, and that's why now I'm willing to get divorced from that person. So 13(1). A second provision is talking about certain guilty. If husband is guilty of committing rape, sodomy, bestiality, in that situation, it is a ground for divorce available to wife only. These 4 grounds are available only to wife. Third, if under section 18 of HAMA, okay, section 18 of HAMA and section 125 of CRPC, if there is any case filed under 125 CRPC by the wife against her husband for the maintenance. Under section 18, a Hindu wife filed a petition for the maintenance under section 18 of Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act. In both the situation, okay, if a judgment is passed by the court and the order is given in the favor of the wife, and now wife is living separate, and after completion of 1 year, there is no cohabitation between the parties, it is also a ground for divorce. Okay, and the last one, marriage was solemnized, and at the time of marriage, the age of wife was below 15. Okay, then she is having a right to repudiate the marriage before 18. Marriage before 15, repudiation before 18. Okay, so these are the certain rights available. 4 rights are available to wife. In under section 13(1), the rights are talking about adultery, cruelty, desertion, conversion, unsound mindedness, leprosy, venereal disease, renounce the word, not being heard from last 7 years. 2 special ground available to both the parties, judicial separation decree passed by court, 1 year completed, and no cohabitation. Restitution of conjugal right, decree passed by the court, 1 year completed, and no cohabitation. 4 specific ground under section 13(2), wife, marriage before 1955, husband is already married. Okay, the second wife is having this right to file a petition for the divorce. Second husband is guilty of committing certain offenses. Then under section 18 of HAMA, under section 125 of CRPC, a case was decided in favor of wife, and there is no cohabitation between the parties after completion of 1 year. It is a ground for divorce. And then marriage before the age of 15, then right to repudiate the marriage before 18. Okay, so these are the grounds available to the parties. Remember, the second provision, specific provision relating to divorce, is given under section 13(b). Okay, it is a divorce by mutual consent. When we are talking about divorce by mutual consent, in that situation, both the parties, they can make an application. Okay, there is no need of any of the ground for the divorce. The parties can make an application ओके अ पिटीशन अ जॉइंट पिटीशन टू द कोर्ट एंड दे कैन मेंशन देयर कंडीशंस. सो अंडर सेक्शन 13B इफ देयर इज अ डिवोर्स बाय बोथ ऑफ द पार्टीज म्यूचुअली इट इज कॉल्ड डिवोर्स बाय म्यूचुअल कंसेंट. एंड इफ देयर इज अ डिवोर्स बाय म्यूचुअल कंसेंट देयर इज नो प्रोविजन फॉर अपील. सो In this situation, if they are under Section 13B, both the parties, they are making a joint application to the court that they are willing to take divorce from each other. Court can pass, court can give a particular separation period, which is minimum 6 months to 18 months. And even after the completion of that time period, there is no cohabitation between the party, court may issue a decree of divorce between the person. And remember, there is no provision for appeal under Section 13B. So these are the provisions relating to the divorce under Hindu Marriage Act. Thank you.